An easy way to make one of these ponytail hats is you're going to knit it straight. You're going to do similar to a gathered bind off in the end, but we need to do one extra step. We need to make eyelets so we could thread an I-cord through it, and then we could make that hole as small or as large as we need. So I did, I think it was 14 or 18 rows of rib, and then I did 44 rows of stockinette, and I need to do the eyelets. Now, you don't have to do every other needle. It's up to you if you want to do that. So what I'm going to do is I am going to see what happens with every fourth needle, which is actually not too bad. I have 3 stitches on the right here and 2 stitches on the left that stay back. So I'm going to use that. Bring those needles out. Then I'm going to take my transfer tool. Now, because I have 2 stitches on the left here and 3 on the right, I'm going to transfer these stitches to the right. You don't have to bring them out to hold. I just tend to do that. And of course, depending on if this is for a child or an adult, how many stitches you're going to have on this. This is going to be a child's hat. And as you see, I'm on the LK150. I think I got 4.5 stitches and 6.5 rows to the inch at tension dial 6 with some Red Heart Super Saver yarn, but it's more of the slippery, the new slippery stuff that's out. But what you're going to do is find your favorite hat pattern and use that to make this hat. Now, just to be on the safe side, I'm just going to make sure I have all the needles out to hold position. This machine here with the front lever forward, it'll knit these needles back into work position. If I had them back, if I had this back here, it would not knit that, and it would skip over it or actually do a tuck. It's when you bring the back lever forward, the needles on the back are being slipped or skipped. So I have my row of eyelets. And that was 10 rows, 11, 12. I think 12 rows is good enough, looking at the eyelets up. This is going to be scrunched up, kind of maybe look like a little flower in the end. Now, it's up to you if you want to decrease these stitches in half. I don't want to do that because I want that top to fluff out, and this is going to be the gathering line after I make the I-cord. So I'm already at 6. If I go to 9 on this, it will not knit a larger stitch. So I have one of 2 ways of dealing with this. Well, if I ended over here, I could do the back stitch bind off. For you left-handers, you could do the back stitch bind off here, and I could even do that here if I want to. But somebody was asking me about binding off. Now, the way these manuals show you, and I'm not really sure exactly what it's called, but you're going to take the first needle and you're going to hand knit that stitch. You're going to put the yarn over that hook and hand knit it. And then you're going to put it on the second needle. Now, you don't want to have that stitch too tight. You want to try to have it as uniform as the stitch on the needles. So there, I just knitted two together. And you just do this down the way. It is very similar to doing a latch tool bind off. Maybe I should call this the latch tool, transfer tool bind off. Anyways, I'm sure you've seen this in some of the manuals. And it's not that bad. Now, before I go on, I do need to take my comb and weights off. And then if I do not want to lose my stitches, I will put a weight just below the area I'm working. Maybe I'll even put a second one over here and just work on down the line. Let me get a close-up of what I'm doing here. So I take this stitch, put it onto the next needle, put the yarn in the hook, and hand knit those together. Put that on the next needle, hand knit those two together. And I'm going to do that all the way down. Now, of course, you want to have, if you're going to do it this way, you want to have this loose, but not too loose, but you don't want it too tight either. So, of course, when you're done, you're going to sew that one seam up. Then you're going to, of course, turn it inside out. And we have this. Now we need to make an eye cord, or you could take some ribbon and thread it through the eyelets here so you could cinch up the top of this hat. So as you noticed, I'm using my LK150 for this project. Now for the eye cord, you're going to cast on 3 stitches. And then you're going to take one of your side levers and put it forward, and the other one over here you're going to keep back. So what happens is when I go from right to left, it knits. When it goes from left to right, it slips. So here, I think you could see that those were knitted. So when I go back, there's the yarn still over here on the left. So it slipped those 3 needles, and now it knitted those 3 needles. On the other Singer metal bed machines, you have the side levers that are actually on the side. The Russell levers are on the front of the carriage. So you're going to do the same. The only thing, you got to put that cam to slip. You're going to put one of these forward, leave the other one back. On the Brother machines, you have 2 part buttons. You're going to push in 1 part button, leave the other one out, go back and forth, and it's going to do the same. For the plastic bed machines, like the KX350, it's set up the same as this, but it calls the levers different. I think these are the part levers, and these are the hold levers, or cams, or something like that. Now, for the Bond machine, what I would do is I would take the cover out, or even lift the carriage up off the bed, put it over, so that it does not knit one way, and then you go back, and of course it knits the next way. I believe the LK100 is very similar. It does have the back levers here, and if I remember correctly, you have to hold those in. So for those machines that you do have to hold it, you're going to hold that lever forward till you get past the needles, then of course let go, and the next pass it will knit it. So make your eye cord as long as you need it. What I will do is, and I'm not sure if my counter is right, I don't even think I reset it at the beginning of this. And when you're doing the eye cord, of course, it's only 1 row for each, so that would be 100, let's see, 236, so 118. rows that I actually did. But I'll do up some more, thread it through the hat, and then cinch it up so that I can make a bow out of it and make sure I have it long enough. I will probably just take another piece of yarn, or if I just take these off, the needles, it should stay, no problem. If it unravels, it's no big deal. I just have to make sure I have the carriage right when I go back to knit more rows. And that's all there is to this hat. So what you want to do is you want to put that back seam in the back and start in the center here and weave the I-cord in and out of the eyelets all the way around, pulling it up as you go. And then when you get to the front here again, then you're going to cinch it up and tie that bow. And I am going to need more rows to this. And there. Okay, so I made the I-cord a little long, but I could go ahead and undo some rows to make it a little bit shorter. But there you have the opening. Or, if you pull it tighter, you can close it up. Now, if you want to make the hat with decreasing so many stitches at the top to have this fit the head a little bit better, what I did was, I normally like to go down to 10 stitches and then I do a gather bind off. But what I did with this one was I went down to, I think, 25 stitches and I bound off that top row. Now all I have to do is take this yarn and sew it down. And I like to have the tails meet up here. Not, I don't like to go all the way down here and then travel the yarn tail back up and weave it in. That's why I do leave a long tail in the beginning, so I could sew up halfway, I could sew down halfway, and then I will take and weave that yarn in and out on the inside there instead of making a knot. Although if you make a knot, it's really, the person ain't going to feel it. So let me finish this up and show you what that looks like. And there's this one all done.